Why? Why couldn't you have just left things alone? Why couldn't you have just gone your own way? It's a big universe. What does it matter whose way is the one that the people follow? My way, your way, do they know any real difference? In the end, they still must be fed. They still must be given borders. How I do that, how you do that, and these are just formalities. One way or another, the people always prove that if you give them enough hope, they'll hang themselves.
Tell me, my friend, can you imagine a place free of boundaries and lies? There's blood on the wind, and it's come all the way from faraway skies.
Of lockdown and safety measures are in place. Civilian casualties and injured persons are being cataloged and reviewed. And most everyone hit the deck when the shooting started. This big green one is beyond code blue.
I'm receiving reports that the environment is very serious compromised. What about the other guy, the human?
It looks like he may require a medevac. Can we get medevac services to come out here?
I wish I knew. Give it a try at least. I could.
No, it's not necessary.
Just stay down, sir. You'll injure yourself further.
No, I've got this.
Crapped all over your boots.
Friggin' drunks. Help me get him out of here, Lieutenant.
It was true. My boots were ruined, but I was still alive. I hadn't expected bounty hunters to be looking for me amidst all this mess, almost a year after the war had ended. I had gone my separate way, back to my life of illegal hooch trafficking, and me and my partner Crunchy had made quite a profit over the last year operating in a galaxy now overrun with disarray and random acts of violence. To radio Crunchy and warn him to turn on the ship's cloak, get the engines rolling so we could take off immediately. My intuition had been nagging me to return here. I didn't know why, yet. All too often it spoke to me in single syllables, and I knew better than to ignore its call. Go back to the planet, it had told me. Go. Unfinished business. Go. I had been here only a short time, and now my life was in danger once again on this planet. I headed out into the night, and once on the street, I popped open my communicator and notified Crunchy of our immediate departure. I held in my other hand the gold plate of the food I had been eating in Hervis, with the full intention of finishing once I was again on board. What I didn't know was that the planet was now crawling with dangerous xenoforms.
You're looking really delicious today.